First up on today's show, Julia Souza brings us back to FHS where we take a look at the senior sign project here in Framingham.
Next, Zak Clayton brings us a brand new edition of everyone's favorite science show, Atom Update.
And finally, Megan Sidmore updates us on what the plan is for Massachusetts reopening and how it will affect the state.
All that and more coming up next on Flyer News. Welcome back to Flyer News Remote. Today is May 19th, and unfortunately, it's the seniors' last week. I'm Miss Adams.
And I'm Aiden Fernando. It is truly unfortunate that this is my last week attending my online classes, and needless to say, it has been a weird senior year.
I've been at FHS for 13 years, and I've never seen anything like this. It is truly heartbreaking to see you guys have a senior year like this. However, thanks to many great families here in Framingham, they were able to help set up a way to give back to your class.
That's right, last week I spoke to four Framingham parents who had set up the Senior Sign Project, and now we have Julia Souza with more on the story.
With the school year ending so abruptly due to COVID-19, many students were left wondering what would happen to the rest of their school year. Senior year is supposed to be a special time, reminiscing on memories with your friends, going to sporting events, and to end the year off with the prom and graduation. Unfortunately, that wasn't the case this year. The virus came to the US, closing schools all over the country, and with social distancing practices in place, a formal graduation just isn't possible right now. Not only was graduation supposed to be a special time for students, but for the parents of the students, watching their child finally move on to the next stage of their life. The parents were just as fed up as the seniors were, and they decided to come together and set up something special for the class of 2020. On Saturday, May 16th, students and parents came together as they set up signs for every student who was graduating. Each lawn sign had the first name and last name of the graduating student, as well as class of 2020. Not only did seniors get their own lawn signs, but they also got a big banner with every single one of their fellow classmates. These signs were not put to replace graduation, but to honor the students' achievements for the past 4 years of hard work. As of now, administration is hoping to have a formal graduation in mid-August. Flyer News will keep you updated on the plans to honor the class of 2020. For Flyer News, I'm Julia Souza. Let's send it back to our anchors.
John Krasinski has started a series on YouTube called Some Good News. He has produced 8 episodes since being in the quarantine. These episodes highlight good news from around the world during these difficult times. Episodes include the cast of Hamilton singing to surprise a young fan, an online prom and graduation for class of 2020, and the cast of The Office singing and dancing for a couple's online wedding. Many celebrities join John Krasinski in spreading these news stories.
The science world is always evolving for me, and it can be quite hard to keep up with, and since I no longer watch Bill Nye the Science Guy, I rely on Zak, who loves science more than Bill.
For me, I find science to be pretty boring. The only thing I care about is helping my students understand the world of calculus. Besides, who doesn't love a good unit circle surprise party, which are technically pop quizzes?
While doing math sounds like fun, I think math actually helps in the world of science, because in physics you definitely need some calculus skills to help you along the way. Maybe you should give science a shot, Miss Adams.
Thanks, Aiden. I have been looking for a new hobby. However, we can listen to Zak in his edition of Atom Update, where he talks about what's new in the science world, and let's see if math can apply to some of his topics.
Hello, and welcome back to another edition of Atom Update. You can find your weekly science news. Welcome back, everyone. I'm your host, Zak Clayton, and today I'll be taking a look at how hydrogen-rich atmospheres on a planet could hold life, and if Pluto has a subsurface ocean. Recently, scientists discovered that life can exist on a planet with an atmosphere of pure hydrogen. This could possibly expand the search for life on other planets. Tests were done on single-celled organisms, which included yeast and E. coli. They were put in various atmospheric conditions that include pure hydrogen, pure helium, and earth air and other gases. The organisms were found to have survived and replicated in every single environment. This may widen the search, but life still needs a form of nutrients to survive, which could exist in liquid water or other substances. If life did exist on a planet with hydrogen atmosphere, if it could talk, it would probably have a high-pitched, squeaky voice, due to hydrogen having the same effect on voices as helium. An ocean below the surface of Pluto may be a possibility due to the new analysis of images from NASA's New Horizons spacecraft. It shows that there could be a vast underground ocean that has existed for 4.5 billion years, and may even interact with the core of Pluto. It also has the possibility to include life. It is unclear the volume and mass of the ocean if it exists. This also raises the question if other objects in the Kuiper Belt have oceans inside of them. This may be a new place to search for alien life. Thank you all for watching this edition of Atom Update, where even the smallest matter can affect the world. Be sure to look forward to the next edition coming up next time. I'm your host, Zachary Clayton, and let's take it back to Aiden and Miss Adams.
In recent news, two Pakistanian women were killed in a so-called honor killing after a video surfaced of them kissing a man. The girls were cousins, one at the age of 22 and the other 24. The video was shown a month ago and was filmed over a year ago, but it resurfaced due to social media this month. After seeing the video, both of the fathers had decided to kill their daughters, and after doing so, they admitted to the police. In the video, a third woman was shown, however, she was not kissing the man, and the officers have a reason to believe she is safe and sound.
It's hard to think that 2 months ago, I was teaching at FHS, and I was able to get my Starbucks every morning and yell at kids as they ran past my classroom. And now, I can't even leave my house without wearing a mask.
For sure, I miss everything about being in your class. Originally, while I was at home, I was waiting until May 4th, when we'd be allowed to come back to school and have the state reopened.
As many of you know, the state is reopening and is among the last to reopen around the U.S. Many people have predicted that reopening would start small and gradually expand back to normal day-to-day life over the next months.
Now we have Flyer News student producer Megan Sidmore with more on Baker's plan to reopen Massachusetts.
Yesterday, Governor Charlie Baker announced what Massachusetts' reopening plan is going to look like. The plan is a slow one that will likely last throughout the spring and summer. Currently, Massachusetts is entering phase one of a three-phase plan to reopen the state. Phase one will last for 3 weeks at a minimum. Gatherings are still limited to 10 people, hotels will remain closed to all but essential employees, and a mask is still required when social distancing is not an option. Starting on May 25th, businesses outside of Boston can start allowing workers to return at 25% capacity. Also on May 25th, places of worship will be able to reopen, again with limited capacity. Additionally, just in time for Memorial Day weekend, beaches and drive-in theaters will be allowed to reopen. There will be heavy restrictions to beach reopenings, presumably like what is happening in California and other places in the U.S., where beachgoers must remain moving and cannot sit down. With that, car washing facilities will also be able to reopen again, however, they are only allowed to clean car exteriors. If reported COVID cases continue on the downtrend throughout the next 3 weeks, then Massachusetts will progress to phase two of the state reopening plan. According to the Boston Globe, phase two will include reopening restaurants and most retail stores, hotels at limited capacity, playgrounds and some youth sports, and crucially for many working families, day camps this summer. Moving to phase two is dependent on how well we do during phase one. Should another outbreak occur, phase one may last longer than 3 weeks. This is a glimmer of hope in what have been such dark times, and Flyer News will keep you updated.
That's all for today's edition of Flyer News. Please like and subscribe to our channel to see more content.
Make sure to follow us on Instagram at Flyer News for updates and behind-the-scenes photos. For Flyer News, I'm Miss Adams.
Now, I'm Aiden Fernando. Have a terrific Tuesday, FHS. Won't you dare back? Just keep your eyes on me. I said you're holding back.